In this video, I'll be showing you the best OBS settings for streaming in 2025. These settings are great for beginners and experienced streamers. Start by going to the Controls dock and open the settings. Head over and select Stream from the side menu. Expand the Service menu. Then, select the website you want to stream on. I'll be selecting Twitch. Click the Connect Account button if available, or use a Stream key if not. Sign into the account you want to stream with. Then, the stream settings will be updated. Go to the Multi-Track Video panel and uncheck the Enable Enhanced Broadcasting option. Go down again to the Advanced Options and uncheck the Enable Bandwidth Test Mode option. Then enable the Ignore Streaming Service Setting Recommendations option. If you are streaming to Twitch, then feel free to enable any of the Twitch chat add-ons if you want. I'll be leaving it set to None for now. Click the Apply button. Then go to the side menu and select Output. Expand the Output Mode options, then select Advanced. Select the Streaming tab if you're not already on it. Then choose an audio track for your stream. In most cases, I recommend using track 1 for simplicity. Set audio encoder to FFmpeg AAC. Then choose if you want to use a VOD track. This feature is only available to Twitch and will use a different audio track for your VOD. You can use this to remove music from your past broadcasts, but still have it in your stream while you are live. Again, for simplicity, I will be selecting track 2. Set video encoder to NVIDIA NVENC HEVC or AMD HW H.265 if available. Alternatively, use NVIDIA NVENC H.264 or AMD HW H.264. These are hardware encoders on your graphics card, which will allow you to get better performance than using X264. However, if you don't have any of the hardware encoder options, then select X264. If you have any issues when using the HEVC or H.265 options, then try using the NVIDIA or AMD H.264 option depending on your graphics card. Set Rescale Output to Disabled, then go down to the encoder settings. Select Rate Control and set it to CBR as it is the best option for constant quality. Set the bitrate to 8000 if you're streaming to Twitch, or 10,000 if you're streaming on YouTube. Although Twitch only has a maximum video bitrate of 6000, in some instances, your stream may get a bump in quality due to the 8000 bitrate. Additionally, if you are a Twitch partner, then your stream will almost always benefit from using 8000. However, the bitrate that you can use will also depend on your upload speed. If your upload speed is above 12 megabit per second, then 8000 will work fine. With an upload speed between 10 and 12 megabit per second, use 6000. And if your upload speed is below 10 megabit per second, then use 4000. Additionally, for YouTube, you will want to use 10000 if your upload speed is above 14 megabits per second. Set keyframe interval to 2, then set preset to P6 slower or P5 slow if you are gaming and streaming on the same PC. If you're just streaming your camera or have a dedicated streaming PC, then use P7 slowest or P6 slower for better image quality. If you experience some stream lag or have a low-end PC, then use P4 medium. It shouldn't lower the image quality too much while providing better performance. Set tuning to high quality and multi-pass mode to 2 passes, quarter resolution. Again, if you have a dedicated streaming PC, then you can use full resolution. Set profile to high, then uncheck the look ahead box and enable psycho visual tuning. Set GPU to 0 and max B frames to 2. Click the apply button, then go up and switch to the audio tab. Find your stream audio track, typically track 1. Then set the bitrate to at least 128. I leave mine set to 160, however, for the best audio quality, you can use 320. If you have audio issues, try selecting 128. Go through and change the audio bitrate for other tracks if you wish, then click Apply. Head back to the side menu and select Audio. Open the sample rate menu and set it to 48 kHz. Then make sure Channels is set to Stereo. Go to the Global Audio Devices panel and select Desktop Audio. Select the device that you listen to your PC and game audio with. Typically, this will be your headset. Some headsets have 2 audio outputs, one for gameplay and one for chat. If your headset has this, then be sure to add it as the Desktop Audio 2 device. Additionally, you may have separate outputs for sound and chat if you're using audio software like SteelSeries Sonar or Elgato Wavelink. Select the first Mic Auxiliary Audio option and add your microphone. iPhone. Then go down and click the Apply button. Head back to the side menu and select the video option. Set base canvas resolution to your screen's resolution or 1920 by 1080. This is the size of your OBS canvas in preview. If you are using stream graphics, then they are most likely designed to be on a 1920 by 1080 canvas. You can find your screen's resolution by right-clicking on your desktop and choosing Display Settings. Select the monitor you're streaming from at the top, then scroll down and find the Display Resolution option. Here you will see your screen's resolution. Set Output Scaled Resolution to 1920 by 1080. This is the best resolution for streaming as it allows any clips or stream to be edited in the typical 1080p most people are used to. If your output resolution is lower than your base resolution like mine is, then set Downscale Filter to Langsos, Sharpen Scaling, 36 samples. Make sure the frame rate setting is set to common FPS values, then set the frame rate to 60. This is how many times the image is updated every second. If you are using a lower bitrate like 4000, then set the common FPS value to 30. This will make your stream look better. Click Apply at the bottom, then go to the side and select Hotkeys. Head to the top and select the Filter box, then type Stream. Select the Start Streaming box, then input a keyboard shortcut. This is a combination of keys that you can press to start your stream without having to use the button in the controls panel. Input another shortcut for the Stop Streaming option. I recommend using the same shortcut so that you can start and stop streaming with the same buttons like an on-off switch. Be sure to add the keyboard shortcut as a hotkey to your Stream Deck if you have one, or add an OBS stream button. Select the filter box again and type in Scene. Here you will see the names of your different scenes, with the option to set a hotkey. Once the hotkey is pressed, your stream will automatically switch to your chosen scene without you needing to open OBS. Click Apply once done, then go back to the side and select Advanced. Go to the General panel and set the Process Priority to Normal. For the video options, I just use the default settings. If yours are different, then feel free to pause the video and copy the settings I have here. Scroll down and find the Stream Delay heading, then uncheck the Enable button to remove any stream delay. This is ideal for a good chatting experience. Go down and click Apply, then OK to close the window. Locate the Audio Mixer dock, then click the three dots next to any of the audio devices. Select Advanced Audio Properties and the Audio Track menu will open. Enable all of your audio devices on your streaming track. This should be track 1 unless you changed it earlier in the video. If there are any audio devices you don't want to be heard on your stream, then uncheck the box for your streaming track. For anyone that enabled a VOD track, you will want to set the audio devices according to your liking. I set my VOD track to track 2. So for this example, I'll enable desktop audio and my microphone, leaving desktop audio 2 unchecked. My full tutorial on separating audio tracks will be included in the description. You can use it to separate your music and gameplay rather than having them both come through your desktop audio. Click the close button once done, and you will now have the best stream settings for OBS. Consider leaving a like if you found the video helpful.